The second problem, randomized quicksort is an extension of quicksort where the pivot is chosen randomly. What is the worst case complexity of sorting n numbers using randomized quicksort? So randomized quicksort is defined in the problem itself. What is it? We have to choose extension of quicksort where the pivot is chosen randomly. If we choose pivot randomly, then what happens to time complexity of quicksort is a question. Example, this is your array, and if you pick an element randomly, then what happens? Example, these are the positions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So any random number, let's say you are using to generate the pivot's position. So that random number, if randomly generates, then it may generate position 1 or position 2 or position 3, anything in, you know, since it is random, anything can happen. Then your pivot's position can be, that means the chosen pivot can either stay here or here or here or here or here. But still worst case is worst case. That means in the worst case, what happens? Whatever the random number is generated, if you go there, still you may see an element which can split your array into unequal parts. Example, what I'm saying is, if the numbers are, let's say, you know, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, something, 7. What if you randomly pick an element, there is a chance that it will be 0, correct? Then if the pivot is 0, what happens? Your array will be split into two parts. 0 one side, all other elements are other side. Still, you know, narrowly then division can be done. So that's why, though it is randomized, so don't expect that your pivot sits in middle. So that's why your pivot can still sit anywhere, then worst case still can happen. And the time complexity will become order of n square, because we know that when pivot goes to last position or first position, then this kind of order of n square occurs, right? So that's why answer is option C.